They're not one of the four best teams in football.
I mean, they're not one of the top four teams in the country, Al. And I think with that poll department, it is ludicrous.
Did it for the fans. We did it for the Clemson family. Appreciate y'all's support.
Hold up, we got a train going. We got a train going. We got the dub. Dodge.
This is mayhem.
Time to just focus on next week. See y'all next week.
Whoa! Let's go!
Another day in the books, baby.
Gang, gang, you know what's going on?
Oh.
I don't know what that is.
I'm the director of student athlete equipment here at Clemson Football.
I'm Abe Reed. I'm the director of equipment for football.
My job entails a lot of just dealing with the student athletes on a daily basis.
Dealing with the student athletes is a huge part of what we do.
Making sure they look good on the field, at practice, and I love it. You know, it's my favorite part is being able to develop a relationship with those guys as well.
We're in the middle of placing our 2020 Nike orders, so I had Isaiah Simmons come in because he's kind of the fashion guy on the team, and sometimes he doesn't like what I pick, so I said, if they don't like it this year, it's all on you, Isaiah. So
we got some guys that are, I wouldn't say high maintenance, but they're very picky, particular with how they look, and I appreciate that because you look good, you play good. They all have certain cleats that they like to wear. Trevor wears the Field Generals. T wears the old Vapor Carbons. Travis wears the old Untouchable Ones. I appreciate that they care so much about it because, you know, I care about it. So to see them care means a lot to me. Whew, man, Mondays, it's just a big cleanup day. So, you know, you got game jerseys, game pants that Abe's back there washing. So our students come in at 1 and they clean game cleats, game helmets. Nash is in here doing game loops, as you can see. The details is what we focus on. That tiger paw right now is, our brand's never been bigger.
You know, we're going to Louisville and it's gonna be a little chilly at the beginning of the game and then transition as the sun warms up and on the turf. So we have fans and heaters reserved for this game for the sideline.
And you know, we got checklists. We make sure we don't forget anything.
Instead of just packing polos for everybody, everybody has a lightweight quarter zip, their shoes, their particular hat. We have a huge checklist for what goes in the truck.
Pack game loops, game cleats, helmets, gloves, nameplates for the lockers.
It's about a 2-week process of planning out what you're gonna do and when you're gonna do it. And then all our dry cleaning came back this morning, so we're building that khaki polo quarter zip loop.
How you do anything is how you do everything. So, You know, I take pride in how our team looks, and so does our whole staff.
And I can put it in the bun. I got my head set.
Lynn gave me a good pitch. You know, lead blocks about your man. Got Sean sprinting down the field.
Anytime you can get an offensive lineman downfield blocking, that's huge because we're some big guys and not a lot of us like running.
I was like, is this play really going to work? I thought to myself, there's no way. Then I actually looked back and, oh my God, he's actually running. And then I had to kick it into high gear and go get the corner.
Well, we were going over this play before the game. I was like, oh Lord, we're giving Travis the chance to throw the ball. He can run the ball, but throwing it, I was a little skeptical.
He was throwing dimes all week in practice. That's why we ran into the second play of the game, because it was working.
We were talking about it all week, but I just was not expecting it to actually happen.
Now the next step is that you gotta throw it to me.
Great play, first turnover of the game. Get momentum going in our direction.
This is the best part right here. Like, what is he doing? That is so funny.
Yeah, it's still crazy to think that actually happened. I guess kind of like dreams starting to come true. Like, that was my first sack.
Yeah, okay. I didn't even see the celebration part of it.
Classic example of being at the right place at the right time and luck. Jordan Williams makes a great play, tips it.
I got a couple fingers on the pass.
That was the first time I've had the ball in my hands since senior year of high school. You could tell I was so surprised when I caught it. I was like, oh man, the ball's right there.
Ooh, that's pretty cool right there.
That's right. Beat my man in front of me, made the play. Fourth down, we off the field.
Joe and PGJ Will, yeah.
With the tackle, yes sir. Uh-huh. Throw the four up, like that, feel me?
Just look at the grit right there. God, I love Trevor.
Anytime Trevor runs the ball, it scares me. I feel like I'm like a mother and like that's my child that I just don't want to get hit. I feel like it's my job to protect him, which it is. So anytime he runs, I'm just like, oh. Trevor's a hard runner, man. I gotta give him props for it. I mean, he really wants to go out there and he's not scared of contact. So he'll go out there, and when you have a quarterback that's willing to put everything out on the line for the team, that's huge. So good to see a good quarterback getting out there and getting dirty.
We watching Trevor, you know, Big Slim. He's scoring a touchdown. Look at him long arms.
Pretty cool.
I'm telling you, we're calling him Tebow now. I mean, look at him.
He's a dual threat.
Hey, careful. You ain't lied. You ain't never lied.
That's a wrap for this week. On the next week to Louisville. Get a good week of preparation in and go out there and take care of business. Go Tigers. First of the month, I'm a running back. Same day, why I'm a running back. Friday, payday, running back. Running back. 48 yards, I run it.
Shout out my social media marketing professor, Miss Colley. Professor Colley, I know you're watching. We're about to have a good time and vlog it up.